Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Divinity Dragon Commander on that there PC. Right, what we're going to want to do right now is continue our efforts to conquer the land by reinforcing the land with a bunch of troops, by another set of troopers here as well. Shift these guys all the way over there. Right, what are we dealing with here? Three troopers. What are we dealing with here? One here, one trooper. Okay, I am thinking what we're going to want to do is send a hunter and three troopers. No, four troopers to attack this area because they've got basically nothing to defend that area with. They've got nothing. They've got nothing. And let's end that turn there, because unless they're able to massively reinforce that area before we... Okay, they've reinforced it a bit. Not massively, but they've given it a bit of a reinforcement. They've also taken that further style. Fuck me, I didn't even realize there's something like that. Okay, so... is there a way we can avoid going into an open battle with this? I'm thinking maybe if we... drop that in. Okay, there we go. We can actually avoid having to fight this battle outright. Let's go. It's a relatively minor battle that would have taken half a decade to deal with otherwise. So we've just already managed to almost immediately take another area. And so, yes. Sorry, that's... Dragon Knight declared Emperor. Winged Love Child is Empire's last hope. Great, that's my new name. Winged Love Child. Edmund! You don't have any shoes. You're wearing a full suit with, like... a puffy shirt and a monocle, but you're not... but you don't have any shoes.
What a sorry excuse for a general Henry is. Drunk as a dwarf again, going on and on about his lost arm. The more liquor disappears down his throat, the more he can still feel it. Wish he had a phantom tongue instead of a phantom limb. The place would be so much quieter.
Well, no, it'd probably still be as loud. He'd just be going, oh, rather than actually speaking. Right, let's go to the bar. When our good friends was called to the bar, I had an appetite fresh and hearty. Right. Actually, let's talk to Scarlet first.
You taught our enemy the meaning of defeat, Commander. But already I'm aching to give them another lesson. Come to battle!
Yeah, you can actually talk to your generals between fights and they will give you an opinion. Also, please note the skeleton barmaid with fruit jammed in her shirt to make it look like she's got cleavage. I don't know why. And clearly wearing a wig as well. I don't know why that's there. It's a very strange thing for them to have put in. Anyway... what do you say, Scarlet? Shall we be victorious in the end?
As far as I can tell, our enemies are quaking firmly in their boots. Good sign as any, really.
They're the generals. How do you feel about them?
About whom, Commander?
Henry.
Excellent chap, that one. Likes his jokes dirty and his liquor plenty. Two peas in a pod, me and him. Well, on and off, that is. Can fight like a demon unleashed as well. Best to have him on our side.
Yep, not going to listen to all this. Right, let's actually just talk to him. Well, that guy's pissed. Right, Henry.
Well, 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 the Dragon Commander himself. Come, sit, drink with me.
I'd rather not.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking.
No, you don't.
He's had a few too many.
Yep, fair enough, you do.
But you'd take to the right too if you had an imp apparatus for an arm. Never told you how I came by this eyesore, did I?
I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm pretty sure that if say, I lived in the Shadowrun universe, or in a universe where I could choose to have a robotic arm, yeah, I'd probably have a robotic arm. I don't know, I'm just that kind of guy, I suppose. I would actively choose to have the cybernetic arm.
'Twas during the great and glorious last stand to save the Empire. Horseshit. We fought like lions so that the king, your bloody father, could scarper with what riches he could hold. But my soldiers did their duty. They died where they stood, and I was left for dead. One of an eye and an arm.
Is this more you giving me shit for what my father did.
Not that any of it mattered. The king's head was shown decorating a stake, like star crowns will the pines come midwinter night. Defeat. Bah. Luckily, a touch of the malt can relieve its bitter taste.
Here we go. Despite your dislike of my father, you stood your ground and did your duty. I hope I'll gain your respect so that you'll stand by me too, should the... Oh, fuck. Give me a minute. Sorry about that. Breathed in wrong and something went down my throat. Bloody hell. I hope I'll gain your respect so that you'll stand by me too, should the situation arise, you awful fucking drunk.
You have the respect of Maxos, and that certainly speaks in your favor. But you'll need to come a long way yet to prove unto me you're not just another pampered prince he yanked away from his mother's teat. So what'll you have then? Mead or milk?
Honestly, I'd rather drink milk, because I don't drink. Okay, throne room. Something's going on in the throne room.
Commander, it is imperative that we should win the war. For our enemies are godless heathens in need of annihilation. To hasten this process, I therefore propose we introduce conscription. For why have young, able-bodied men sit around or do menial tasks when they could be serving in your armies instead?
And here we actually run into one of the main political elements of the game, is that every now and again you are called to your throne room and petitioned by one of the one or more of the chaps, one or more of the counselors, and then you must hear all of their opinions and then give a yay or a nay. Many of these do have specific effects on your actual battles. I believe conscription, if you support it, will, I think, give you more recruits at the beginning of most fights. So you actually have more starting resources. However, you've also got to deal with the fact that, number one, that's going to piss off a number of the councillors and thus a number of the populations. I think, in fact, I think it just about pisses off everyone if you do conscription. And, I think it might have some economic problems. And there's also the moral issue of forcing people to go to war when they don't want to. Right, we've heard Yorick. Let's hear Oberon.
Commander, even the most peace-loving elf won't deny that in these dark times of war, allowances have to be made which we would otherwise condemn. Conscription, though, goes too far. Let those that wish to fight for our cause do so, but let's not force men away from their families if they feel it is their duty to stand by them.
Okay, we've heard your opinion, Falstaff.
Conscription may have somewhat of an ill ring to it, Commander, but it might be worth consideration nonetheless. There's not a dwarf that won't take up his axe for the Empire, but elves! A three-fingered man could number their volunteers on one hand. Time to get these weaklings into shape.
Yeah, it seems everyone's a bit racist.
I don't think conscription is a very good idea, Commander. Not only should a life of soldiery be an individual's choice rather than an obligation, but by drafting so many young men into the army, you're draining our economical reserves. So please don't forget your political obligations because of your military ones.
Yeah, there, she just brought up the fact that this will have a negative impact on the economy. Okay, Trinculo, let's have a listen.
Here's an imp's perspective, Commander. More soldiers equals bigger battles, and bigger battles equals more explosions. Win-win. Granted, it's a bit of a simplistic perspective, but imps will have their fun, you know.
You're a bit of a psychopath. Okay, so who's for this? The undead, the dwarves, and the imps. Who's against it? The elves, the lizards, and me, on moral grounds. You know, almost the couple of other times I've played this game, I've supported conscription. Let's say no and see what happens.
Your refusal is no more than an encouragement, a celebration even of cowardice. Those who do not step up for the glory of the gods by themselves should have been forced to do so.
Yes, you can also go through and ask everyone for their opinion of the nay response.
Thank you for disagreeing with Yorick, Commander. War is a demanding mistress, and if we give her all she wants, we shall lose our humanity in the process.
Fair point, although you have no humanity to begin with, because you're an elf.
If no conscription means there will remain more dwarves in the army than there are elves. Our hope will be duly recompensed, Commander. We fight so that they may tend to their bloody vegetable gardens in peace.
Yep, he's not fucking pleased.
Very good. I must say, though, I was surprised Falstaff didn't pull the economy card like I did. Conscription might well have drafted some of his precious brewing masters into the military. If those were killed, entire dwarven nations would revolt.
It's actually a fair point. It's weird that he didn't mention that, because he is a money-grubbing psycho.
Commander, here was me agreeing with one of Yorick's proposals, and still you disagree. You won't see an opportunity to please both imps and undead pop up again in a hurry.
Yeah, so even he is aware that imps and undead tend to disagree with each other quite violently. Right, strategy map. On we go. Let's take that land over. And now, let's shift a large number of our forces into this area to just take it outright. Although, actually... Yeah, there we go. Because, yeah, we're almost certain to win there. So if we're lucky, that's just another battle we don't actually have to fight. End our turn. Frankly, it'd be stupid to try and send troops out of that area. I think even with that, we're still going to win. Still, we'll go with Edmund. Yeah, Edmund. Yep, didn't lose a single troop. He just ate shit with that one, didn't he? I'm afraid. Poor chap. Henry unfit to be a general, but don't quote me on that. Lord Edmund confides. Great, good. Stop fucking gossiping about each other to the Rivalon Times, you bastards. And yeah, as you can see, because of our decision, the political leanings have changed. Most of the people are slightly more annoyed at me, whereas the elves and lizards are quite pleased. And we got that. And the population's motivation has increased by 10%. The seven curse you. Your luck has decreased by 2%. Great. Because, of course, we had the mad notion of disagreeing with the fucking psychotic religious zealot undead.
Fie upon Edmund's pride, Commander. The lizard lords have granted him the honor of representing our mighty military on a diplomatic mission of utter import, and he gets his knickers in a twist because it comes with a spot of sacrament alien to our ways.
It's always nice when even the representative of the lizards is like, fucking Edmund, man, he's...
I should think it would be good fun to attend an imp ceremony. Something is bound to blow up. Isn't that what the generals normally like?
Yeah, probably. That's actually the weird thing about Prospera. She's probably actually She... If you looked at a photograph of her, she looks like the most dickheadish of the counselors, but she's actually the most reasonable of them. It's really odd. Sorry, I'm just pulling my, so if you can hear this, I'm just pulling the, one of my curtains down. To the bar! Right, what's going on?
Imps, Commander. Are they not truly the lowliest of all the races?
Not really.
Were it not for the hint of demon cunning in their blood, we most probably wouldn't speak to them as much as serve them for supper with a series of seasonal stuffings. As it is, however, the lizard lords have deemed it fit to strengthen the military cooperation between ourselves and those demoniacal dewdrops.
Well, they're quite important given the fact that I'm pretty sure all of our technology is based on shit they did.
I'd exhale an existential sigh upon the hearing of such folly, yet give it no further thought but for one devilish detail in the treaty. It is I, as our foremost general, who must, quite literally, stoop to inspect their armies. An impish high priest will be present, figures fit for farce that are greeted and received with ridiculous amounts of highly ritualized protocol.
Okay, it seems everyone in this game likes alliteration.
As Henry might say, Commander, I'd rather lick marmalade from an orc's behind than bow to an imp. My very reason for currying your draconic benevolence at this hour. Certainly I have your blessing to abstain from these grotesque formalities and tend to business rather than etiquette.
No, I don't care if you're jumping through. I don't care if they have you jumping through hoops. If a courtesy is demanded, you must deliver upon it. Such are the rules of diplomacy, you uppity, cold-blooded shit.
Your wish, my command, et sorry, et cetera. But if there indeed be hoops, the snapping of little necks will be added to the ritual.
Followed by your execution, I shouldn't think. Henry, do you have an opinion?
I must say, I don't envy Edmund, Commander. He's to bow and scrape before an imp of all things. If 'twere any other general, I'd publicly protest. But that conceited tosser deserves to kiss dust once in a while. Remind him he walks the earth just like the rest of us. Well, except you, perhaps.
Yes, because I fly. It's one of these amazing things. I can physically fly.
Triumph begets triumph.
Yep, don't care. Moving on. Moving on up to East. Actually, no, let's go to the engineering bay before we head out for another battle. Let me get an advanced ironclad. No, I don't want an ironclad. Yes, armor. We want to be able to build our own armors. Armors being, if I recall correctly, kind of like, I think they're kind of almost, like, not quite artillery, but they're kind of heavy tank kind of situations. Effective against buildings and other medium class, yeah. Not, like, the strongest things in the world, but they can be rather useful. In fact, these are armors, aren't they? Okay, let's pile the armors in here. Yep, there we go. We'll continue pulling armors out of places. Send one there. I don't want to ever... I never want to leave any of my lands undefended. Just in case the enemy ends up coming around with a frigging, And just to make sure the enemy doesn't walk in with a transport and just take it over by virtue of the fact that there's no one there. Which they can do. That is definitely a thing they can do. Like that, for example. Shit. Oh, we're gonna have to fight. Chance to win, bugger all. Oi. Okay, what can we do? Oh, very little. Okay. Partner, here we go. So, put the passive in there. Start the battle. This is going to be a bitch. We may very well lose. But if we lose, tell you one thing. We're going to do our damnedest to fuck them over. So that if we do lose, we can just march some dudes from the capital back and take it over that way. Although, frankly, technically, we shouldn't have a capital. This is one of the problems with this game is that, like, just functionally, you have a capital. Even though the quote-unquote capital of the Empire is the Raven, that's a flying ship that travels around. We don't have a land-based capital. Really.
Let's get this dance of death started. Your unit will roll out momentarily, Commander.
Already.
We're out of recruits,
I'm fairly concerned about how well this could possibly go. Because,
construction in progress.
Yeah. Already I'm worried.
The Emperor's enemy is my enemy. Trooper awaiting your instructions, Commander.
Because, yeah, they've got...
Ready to follow you.
I think they're even coming in via fucking transport as well. Gonna be problematic. In that case, I should probably build my defenses over here.
Anti-ground turret completed.
Oh wait, this is quite literally where we were before.
Troopers awaiting your decision, sire.
Yeah, this is literally where
we'll
we were before.
Them one leg at a time. Your unit will roll out momentarily, Commander.
I just hope we can drown them in a small army of troopers. Not bloody likely. Yep, we're dying already. Hang on, capture that, please. Oh god, they all exploded. Oh dear. Granted, I do believe that what just happened was, granted, I do actually think we may not be as fucked at the minute. You know what? Let's stop sending him out there. We'll just wait for the dragon to get for us to get the dragon back, and then we can capture it that way.
Just blow it up with the dragon. Where's that? Oh, it's an army of troopers, so not something I have to worry about. God damn it. Come on! Come on! Thank you. Very good. Let's go fuck up these troopers. Hi! How are you? How's it going? I'm blowing you up. It's fun, isn't it? See how your bloody military works when you have to deal with a dragon! Oh, bloody hell. Just keep locking up every now and again. Memo to self, stop fucking putting my feet on the desk. That's causing issues. And if I'm... correct, I think very shortly, I will have... okay, yep, that's essentially... Yeah, that's dealt with. Okay, now we can actually go and start attempting to take over. What's that? Is that a battle forge?
Construction in progress.
Right.
We'll crush them one leg at a time.
Let's go back to starting to take places over, I think.
Unit is being manufactured, Commander.
Yes, we can take them. Even into death. Just because we started out at a... at a disadvantage doesn't mean we must remain at a disadvantage.
The Emperor shows us the way.
Come on, clippity-clop your ways over there.
Unit is being manufactured.
Waste all of my troops. Unit is being waste all of my recruits again on just taking this area over. Oh, they're sending out more of these guys. Here we go! Surprise! Dragons! Unrelated, that is quite a nice touch. I'm not sure if you could see that, but where my fire breath has struck trees, there are still fires going on in that little forested area. Right, let's drop a couple more. Burn the forests to piss off the elves. Oh, yes. And out of the world we go. With very little explanation as to exactly where he goes when that happens, but whatever.
Construction underway, Commander.
Just need to
construction in progress.
Set that up.
Unit is being manufactured, Commander.
And three more.
Trooper ready to march.
Mm-hmm.
Trooper awaiting your instructions, Commander.
Very good.
Let's get this dance of death started. We'll crush them one leg at a time.
Park everyone over here.
Pay me in blood. The Emperor shows us the way. Empty ground turret.
Gotta be honest, it might just be because I've played entirely too much stuff based on Warhammer 40k, but I can't hear them talk about the Emperor without thinking God Emperor of Mankind.
That's impossible, Commander.
Too far
that's
away from my own troops. Okay. I can see more enemy troops. Basically, at the minute, my goal is essentially just to keep them out of... fuck off. Out of this middle section. Because if I can keep them out of that middle section and take it for myself, then they've got two outposts, whereas I've got three. And I've already destroyed their initial troops. So we've both lost all of our initial investments. Ow, 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 ow. I need to go away before I die. Okay. But yeah, so I've already lost almost all of my initial investments.
Let's get this dance of death started. That's impossible, Commander.
Nope. Not letting it happening. Not letting you do it. I refuse to let you drop that many fucking grenadiers on my side of the battle. It's not happening. It's not happening. Yeah, that's what I think of you and your fucking grenadiers. Hi. Let me just... let me just keep doing this to you and yours. Let me... just continuously throw explosives at you from afar. While also madly... dodging what flailing attempts you make at kit. Oh, yeah, there I go. Okay. I still think I've done quite a distinct amount of damage to it. Build these so they can't cause a problem. Build a battle forge, war factory, and a citadel. I will continue holding them off. Again, the joys of being the dragon in this game are somewhat absurd. Just the huge advantage having this like massively mobile anti-troop unit that you directly control is—it's silly. It just makes the game like ludicrously easier than it really should be. I'm gonna build armors. Factory completed. Your unit will soon be ready. From there. Recruitment citadel completed. Great, what's my phone go? Okay. Even into death. I'm sorry, my phone went off and I got distracted. Just trying to think at the moment. Ready to march. I don't have enough of a construction. Okay, there we go. Build that so I can build hunters from that area. Summon up my dragon. Blow up their small number of troops. Because it's not enough that I beat them. I need to embarrass them. I need to leave them with their shit pushed in. No. I need to completely ruin their lives. I need to ruin their tiny digital lives. I can't remember if hunters can actually... no, hunters can't attack me. Good. Good. Blow up their most useful troops. There we go. And... nuke my way across the battlefield.
Your unit will work momentarily, Commander.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nope, can't do 5. So let's get one more of that. Few more of that.
Hunters off the leash.
And very soon, we will be able to march these fuckers into the enemy base and ruin them. It's probably one of the reasons why I'm not particularly good at strategy games, is because I am very, I think the term is turtler. Like, I turtle like hell. I just kind of... I put myself into defensive positions and then basically hide and just build massive armies. Which, honestly, is a hell of a... it's just kind of a legitimate tactic when used against computer players that aren't that good at handling that or capitalizing on the fact that that's how I behave. But against human players, I am useless. Absolute wreck against human players. Group. You know, that's the thing. I'm not even particularly concerned about the grenadiers at this point. I'm more concerned with the fucking hunters. Because the hunters are what's gonna hurt me. Oh shit, wait. No. No! No! Need to get out of that. Okay. That's considerable force. Move on. In we go, lads. Fucking belching fire and smoke as we do. There is something impressive looking about that, isn't there? Just this kind of small, this kind of cloud of belching smoke. Vanishing. To battle! I'm thinking we should be this far should be fine. The troopers will almost certainly eat a lot of shit, but we have hunters and armors there as well, so we should be fine. And I died. As I somewhat expected. Right, armors, deal with that turret. Troopers, if you please. I've got big guns, I cannot.
Troopers awaiting your decision, sire.
You found me, did you?
Nope, fuck 'em. They're trying to get around us. They're trying to get around us. We can't allow that to happen.
You're blowing my cover. On the trail.
Forward. Forward motion to battle. Yeah, we've won. we've won. Just a matter of dealing with these last few, this last outpost here. Then we'll be covered. Let's burn down the forest. Because I can. What happens if I spit, like, acid? I think nothing. Judging by that, I think nothing happens when I spit acid into the forest. Actually, no. Spit it into you, because you are not already on fire. No, it burns it as well. So I basically have an entire forest that's on fire. Grand. From acid.
My acid spit will burn you.
Come on, troopers, head out. And I believe we've won. Grand. Victory! We kicked the shit out of them from what appeared to be a massive disadvantage at first. Always a good situation to find yourself in, able to defeat the enemy after coming at them. Rather after being assaulted when they had a clear advantage. Not enough of an advantage to deal with Francis Urquhart. However, nope, 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 ah. No one can fuck with Francis, I mean the partner. And the one troop we had there survived. Great. Emperor subjects, general to impish humiliation. They will tell you to roll over. You roll over. Emperor's slayer victories, fact or fiction. Great. Ah, we got some more mercenaries. From, yep. And the enemy's troopers will do 75% less damage. Jesus, that's ridiculous.
It would seem Edmund has come back from his inspection duties among the imp armies already. I had expected tales of mayhem to precede his reappearance. In fact, I bet Henry the lizards and imps would be at war as soon as he set foot among them. But no. All the better, of course. Though a little disappointing.
We'll see what happened with our dear Edmund in the next episode. But for now, that's gonna have to be all for me for now. Yes, I'm aware of how stupid that sounded. But yeah, it's going to have to be off me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Cyrus Thinker. And as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that. I could have been having a really shitty day when I recorded that. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. Anyway, just here to say that I have a Twitter account that you can follow if you want occasional updates of random thoughts from me, and that if you're feeling generous, feel free to donate to my Patreon campaign. Every penny donated there makes life easier for me generally and slowly goes towards me getting a better gaming PC. Well, that's that. It's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.